A team of researchers from MIT, Columbia, Cornell, and Harvard universities has developed computationally simple robots that connect in large groups to move around, transport objects, and complete other tasks. Made of plastic, magnets, and basic electronics, each robot in this so-called particle robotics system is almost static when isolated, designed only to expand and contract. But when you put a number of these robots together, they move in time, and the system becomes much more robust.
We are interested in developing the science of autonomy, particularly when multiple robots work together. And for this reason, we designed a robot we call the particle robot. The robot is actually inspired by the idea that natural organisms have cells, and these cells connect together and work together to form larger organisms. What we would like to do with these robots is study the mechanisms, the principles, and the algorithms that enable these robots to come together to form larger structures that are mobile, that can be used to perform tasks.
Because of their circular shape, individual robotic particles can assemble into many configurations and fluidly navigate around obstacles, squeeze through tiny gaps, and move things along. Uniquely, none of the individual robots, or particles, as the researchers refer to them, directly communicate or rely on each other to function. So particles can be added or subtracted without any impact on the larger group.
So in each of the robots, we design this kind of magnetic connectors, which will allow multiple of the particles to connect together at any orientation. And each of the robot can only expand and contract.
And so by making and breaking connections and employing expansion and contraction, an individual module is able to help move an entire system of particles in the desired direction.
Traditionally, robots are designed for one purpose, comprise many complex parts, and stop working when any part malfunctions. Robots such as these could enable more scalable, flexible, and robust systems.
Yep. In our future work, we plan to add sensors to this robot to detect the pushing and pulling force of each particle. And we also plan to build a new system made of much smaller particles.
One day, they hope to have robotic cells that can be assembled in different ways to make different robots, and perhaps even contain the ability to develop themselves. As the system's goals change, its body could change too.